प्रेशर एंड
प्रेशर एंड फ्लूइड बिहेवियर, फ्लूइड बिहेवियर, फ्लूइड बिहेवियर अंडर हाइड्रोस्टैटिक्स, अंडर हाइड्रोस्टैटिक्स. ओके, सो दिस प्रेशर डेंसिटी ऑल दिस वी आर डिस्कसिंग अंडर फ्लूइड्स विच इज एट स्टेशनरी. ओके, सो दैट इज व्हाट आई सेड, आई मेंशन हाइड्रोस्टैटिक्स. सो whenever we discuss all these points, we consider the liquid or gas is stationary, they are not moving. Okay, so that is the condition. So you can write the first point regarding pressure. The pressure is the same. First point, pressure is the same, pressure is the same, pressure is the same at points in horizontal level, at points in horizontal level of a fluid, horizontal level of a fluid. So what do you mean by that? Okay, pressure is same at points in the horizontal level of a fluid. That means if you consider a container, just understand, no need of writing. If you consider a container like that, and there's a amount of liquid is this much. Now if you consider a point A in the liquid, and you just assume that this water is exerting pressure from all the sides to that particular point, everywhere in that case it will be same. Similarly, another point is there, B and A, both are parallel means they are in the same height, they are in the same height or depth. That means how much pressure is acting on A will be the same pressure will be acting on B. That is horizontal level. So all the points, suppose you consider another point C, so pressure at all A, B, C in a horizontal direction, they are equal. So if suppose this is acting a pressure of 10 newton per meter square, then this also acting at 10 newton, in this also acting 10 newton. So that is the meaning of the first point. So pressure, for this what is the condition? Fluid should be rest. If fluid is not moving, pressure will change, because velocity is a matter. So that we will be learning later. So in this case, fluid should be stationary. That's the reason whenever you pump the water into a water tank, it is stagnant. Stagnant means it is at rest. Therefore, the pressure of the liquid can withstand by the walls, by the cement walls, because it is not moving, it is just remaining stationary. Okay. But if the liquid is moving, you know that due to flood, what happens? If the flood is means the water level rising and velocity is increasing during the flood time, and all this water level, the flood water is hitting on a wall or hitting on a house, will collapse because of the pressure of the liquid, since it was moving. Clear? So that is the reason. So flood, why the flood is big, flood, tsunami, all these are giving a disastrous effect. Whenever the fluid is moved, there's a chances of high pressure exerted by this flood water is hitting on a wall or hitting on a house. That is why houses are getting collapsed. We have landslides. So we have all these things are happening in our daily life because of the effect of the pressure. So at the same level, pressure is same, but depending upon intensity, velocity, and velocity coming later, we will be learning later. So I am telling what's the importance of this point here. Clear? Okay. Now, second point, same point, but little more specifically, second point, the pressure at a point, pressure at a point, pressure at a point, in a fluid at a rest, in a fluid at rest, at rest, is the same in all direction, is the same in all directions. So here, what is the difference between first point and second point? First point, I am discussing about the same horizontal level, but I also have indicated the pressure. Arrows are coming from all the parts of the liquid. So that is the second meaning. Same in all direction. Pressure at a point in a fluid at rest is same in all directions. Okay. So at this particular point A, particular point B, particular point C, if the liquid is exerting pressure from every side, since it is immersed in the water, since it is immersed or it is sank in the water and it is at rest, naturally the pressure will be same in all direction. So you can just think about a fish which is living under the sea, a fish which is living under the sea, an object, a stone which is under the water. If the sea is not turbulent, not disturbed, suppose the sea is calm, on fish, every object under the water will experience same pressure. So they are experiencing a stability under the sea. So this will help the aquatic plants, aquatic species to live under the water, under the water. But if suppose a ship is moving in a habitat of a fish, you can see that the water get disturbed, the fishes will be run away from that particular places. Okay, so this is the reason. So aquatic plants, aquatic species, they live under the water without any problem, because when the liquid is at rest, all the forces which is acting on that particular species or particular fish is same. Clear? And also, the fish is another matter. Fish also is a small creature if you compare to the amount of the water. So even sometimes the water is turbulent, it may not affect the fish much. The reason is that the mass of the fish is very much negligible compared to the amount of the water which is acting on. So that they can move. So that is another water point. And it is not only pressure. There's so many reasons. Is the volume, temperature, all these things are related. At present, we are only learning a particular quantity alone. But I already told you, universe is not standing because of one single force. There's a lot of forces which is acting inward, outward, everything. So once it become equal, Newton's third law, action and reaction force. So every part, fish also experiencing action and reaction force. That's the reason for it. Clear? Okay. So that is the second point. I think it's clear to you. Next one, next to the third point under this, a change in pressure. Now what is now coming to the point? Suppose if there is a change in pressure, what happened? So third point, a change in pressure at any point, a change in pressure at any point, at any point in a fluid within a closed container. So the word closed container has a importance here. It's not open. Within a closed container, at any point, a fluid within a closed container at rest will be transmitted will be transmitted to every point, transmitted to every point without any change. So this is another thing. Suppose there is a change in pressure, how these aquatic plants and animals, all these things are withstand this pressure. That is third point. A change in pressure at a point in a fluid within a closed container. It is applicable if you suppose the closed container at rest. Suppose liquid is at rest. It will be transmitted to every point. So one small disturbance, it will be transmitted to every point. Okay. And it can be seen in a pond. You know, the pond, we can say the pond is the water is accumulated in a particular place. Suppose it is not closed, but still you can see that if you throw a stone, what do you see in that? If you throw a stone, what do you see in the water? What do you see, Achyut, if you throw a stone on a calm pond?
The water will
get disturbed. Okay. Yeah. Actually, you are throwing a stone in a small point, correct? But what happened? The water get disturbed, correct?
So this is for longer.
It will be disturbed. You can see the ripples are forming in circles. Clear? Yes. So that is the effect of this point. So if there's a change in a small pressure, if a pond is not closed to container, but still the water has been withstanding or collecting in that particular pond only. It is not going out. So in that case, maybe atmospheric pressure is less. That is why it does not have much effect. Okay. But you see a plastic container. Your plastic container, you fill the water. You fill the water in a plastic container and you just crush that water bottle. You can see that the water get inside also. Bottle get crushed, then naturally the water has a small disturbance within that. Okay, why? Even you are applying a pressure in a particular point, but still it will be transmitted to every point without any change of the pressure or anything. Water get disturbed, but there is no increase or decrease of volume of the water. In a closed container, there is no increase or decrease of the volume of the water. They just disturb. So that is the point of third. Now, and this point is based on which? So this point is based on, we are learning Pascal's law. This point is based on Pascal's law. So these are the three points important to the liquid, but the third point is based on Pascal's law. I think 9th standard you have learned. What do you mean by Pascal's law? So what is a Pascal's law? If you pressure apply on a particular point in an enclosed container of the fluid, the pressure is equally transmitted. Pressure is equally transmitted to all. So you can write the next heading, Pascal's law. Under this. So these are three points are over relating the behavior of the fluid and the pressure. Now we are learning implications of Pascal's law and how this properties are verified or applied in our daily life. So that is what we are going to see. So next heading, Pascal's law. One minute. So this is a Pascal's law also we have learned in 9th standard. So something new in that, it is the third point, that is Pascal's law. But we can state it in the case of a law. So Pascal's law has been invented by French scientist Blaise Pascal. It is invented by the French scientist Blaise Pascal. And since it has been discovered by the Pascal, we call it, it is as Pascal's law. That is the word came. And according to Pascal's law, we also have the SI unit of the liquid pressure or fluid pressure or gas pressure in terms of Pascal. That is why the instead of Newton per meter square, according to pressure, we have force by unit area. So unit is Newton per meter square. Since because of the Pascal's law, we got another unit is Pascal. Pascal, or we write it Pa. So that is how the other SI unit is come. So this is the Pascal's law. So Pascal's law, or the principle of transmission of fluid pressure. So Pascal's law, also known as principle of transmission of fluid principle. And it is a principle. So you can write it down, this line what I have given. It states that, Pascal's law states that pressure exerted anywhere in a confined incompressible fluid is transmitted equally in all directions throughout the fluid. That much is enough. This is its implication. What is the implication of that? Okay. So physics is related to Max. Why? Because Blaise Pascal is a mathematician, not a physics scientist. He is not a physicist, but he is a mathematician. But he invented a very important theory of physics. So if I ask you what is Pascal's law, you only have to write, it states that pressure exerted anywhere in a confined incompressible fluid, confined means closed container, transmitted equally in all direction. And what is the implications of Pascal's law? That is the next line. Such that pressure variations remain the same. There's no change in that. It will be applicable only in the closed container. So this is also known as transmission of fluid pressure. Have you completed, children? Okay. Now we are going to prove Pascal's law, the proof of Pascal's law. So this is in your textbook, it is given. So Pascal's law, we are going to prove in terms of, I think this is not come properly, so I will draw a little bit. So maybe merging into the PPT, there is some problem. It's not so much clear. Okay, so we are going to prove that Pascal's law on the basis. We are going to consider a beaker. In beaker, it consists of some water at the brim. And we are going to consider a small liquid column in terms of a prism. In terms of prism means, if it is water is here, you are going to take the water in terms of a triangular form. Why it is so? Because I told you Pascal is a mathematician. So naturally, there's a chances for him to incorporate triangles and cylinder into it. So our pressure study is going to be in terms of a liquid column. Usually, we take it a liquid column in terms of a cylinder. Then area of the liquid, area of the gas and all we can be found out in terms of the area and volume of the cylinder. So that is the implications. Okay. So in the first case, what he has done, it is in your textbook, page number 248. So this picture you will see it, page number 248, figure 10.2. So in this, he has considered a liquid column in terms of a prism, and we are only thinking about the water level which is inside the triangular form. That's it. So it's not that he kept a triangle inside, not like that. We are just taking the water in that particular shape. Okay. Similar, if you consider a cylindrical liquid column, the meaning is that we are considering the water column in terms of cylinder. Why? Then only we can prove this Pascal's law in terms of mathematics. That's why. Okay. So we have got a triangular column of liquid, and it is given as A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. So you know triangular means it has got how many shapes, you know. It's a prism. So naturally it has how many faces? 3 faces. So you have the first face. By more clearly I can draw separately. So this is how a triangular prism look like. So the first face, which is what you see now, it is ABC, and another side it is D, inside part is E, this is F. So that is how it is indicated. Then we have mentioned each triangle is as theta, an angle theta. So we consider angle A is theta 1. Angle C in the picture is given as angle theta 2. Okay. Why we are going to get an equation of pressure? We have to prove whether pressure is same at all points. That is why, and Pascal's law. So if you want to prove the Pascal's law, first we have to prove pressure at a particular point is same in all directions. Okay. And there is a force acting on first phase AC. There the force is acting, we consider as FB. And there's another force is acting perpendicular to BC. That phase, it is FA. And there is another force which is acting in this position, it is FC. So this is how the picture is given in your textbook. FB, FC, FA. So three forces are acting on this particular triangular prism liquid column. FA, FC, FB. Okay. So you can write down. Consider an fluid element. Consider a fluid element in a container filled with fluid which is at rest. Let A, B, C, D, E, F. Just write like that. Let A, B, C hyphen D, E, F. A, B, C hyphen D, E, F. Is the fluid element in the form of a right angled prism. consider this fluid element is very small. Consider this fluid element is very small, so that every part of it is assumed to be at the same depth with negligible gravity. Whether it's a liquid or gas, gravitational force is acting on every object. Okay, so that's why we are ignoring the gravitational force effect. Why we are ignoring? Yes,
ma'am. Can you say the sentence before every part of?
Okay. Consider. This fluid element is very small. Consider the fluid element is very small. So that every part of it is assumed to be at the same depth with negligible gravity. Okay, so we want to prove it, so we just ignore all the external forces acting and we consider this water element. If this fluid element is very small, and therefore every point A, B, C, D, everything, and D, E, F, its entire thing is at the same depth, we consider, then only we can prove it. Okay, so next line, let the fluids exert pressure PA PB and PC on element at points A, B, C, D, E, and F. That means P acting on A, so corresponding D also comes at the other side. Two sides of the triangle. No, that is why I have mentioned. So we just consider first A, B, C. Then only we can prove. The remaining D, E, F, we just ignore. We first prove at A, B, C, pressure A, pressure B, pressure C acting. Similarly, same pressure is acting on D, E, and F of other side of the container, because we can only see one dimensional picture over there. That's why. Okay. F, A, B, C, D, E, and F on the faces. So we consider three faces related to this on the faces BEFC, ADFC, and ADEB. ADEB. Denoted by area. AA, AB, and AC respectively. How do you understand this is AD, BEFC and all? Okay, if you draw here, first one is BEFC. So you have to consider this bottom part, B, E, F, C, the bottom part of this picture, that is B, E, F, C. Then A, D, F, C. So A, D, F, C means A, D, F, C, this one. Then if you look closely, the last one is A, D, A, B. A, D, E, B. So that is why. We are taking the rectangular faces, triangular face, no? There are three rectangular faces. So that is what we have taken. Okay. Then, next line. Consider right angle ABC. Then, if you consider the rectangle ABC, in that faces, the forces are acting, FB is acting on top, FC is acting. Consider triangle ABC. Then by Pythagoras theorem or sides of the triangle, or we call triangle law, sides of the triangle, we can write more than Pythagoras, it's the sides of the right angle triangle, we can write FB sine theta is equal to FC. FB sine theta is equal to FC. FB cos theta. If B cos theta is equal to FA. AB sine theta is equal to AC. AC and AB cos theta is equal to AA. Why are we are taking this? We are resolving the force acting on this part, because pressure is equal to force per unit area. So force acting on this particular points ABC or the faces BFC, ABCD. So all that. When I say ABC, you understood that it is the faces we mentioned. Okay. So we are considering force component resolving into sine theta, cos theta, and area also resolving into sine theta and cos theta. So that is what we are considering. FB sine theta is equal to FC. So if you look at the triangle, you will get sine theta is equal to FC by FB. If you take it this faces. Because here it is, there is a theta here. Here it is a theta. Here the force is acting FB. Here it is FC. So if you consider as a right angle triangle, so you will get it that FC is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. So opposite side by hypotenuse means it will be FC by FB. That is what we are getting the answer. FC is equal to FB sine theta. Clear? Similarly, cos theta, if you consider, cos theta means adjacent side, no? Adjacent side, it is here, FB here, FB, this is the adjacent side, FA, a force is acting here. So, FB cos theta is equal to FA by FB. So, that is what we are getting this equation like that. I hope you understood. Okay, any doubt how we got this equation, children? I think you are learning trigonometry, you will understand. Clear? Any doubt, children, how I got that FB cos theta? Okay, it's a time up. If you cannot understand, I will explain next class also, if you want. Okay? Tell me, you just go through it and then your textbook page number 248. So, when you come back, you come join me in the class 12:25, because by the time I come here 10 minutes, you can take the gap after your max class, then join me at 12:25. Clear? So then we continue with this. Clear? Thank you.